That's what I want to walk into PowerPoint first. Let's go back to, go to your, wherever you are. If you're here or if you're in your flyer or whatever you created, if I was going to go to PowerPoint, where would I go?
To the waffle.
To the waffle. And then from the waffle, where would I go?
PowerPoint.
So let's look at this for a moment because this is where, I don't know, I saw this and this is where I kind of struggle because I use Google a lot. But this was kind of like the deal breaker for me. I was like, okay, I can have all these really cool templates and all this really cool stuff, and I can have it on any computer I want, and I can move things around. This was probably the piece for me that I was like, this is really cool. So I want you to look at some of the templates because Microsoft has done a lot to create some really cool PowerPoint templates. And so if you scroll through, quite a few different ones, and there's even more. So if you click on more, I was shocked to see these when I was playing around with this earlier today. There's more than the last time that I was in. And the cool thing about this, I was playing around with this one. So I'm going to open it just so you can see kind of some of the differences with it. So as you're looking at it, you'll notice there's even more. So if you didn't like that particular template, you could click down here, and there's even more different types of templates. So I'm going to click on this one just so you can see some of the different ones. So lots of different ones out here that really are kind of different. There are even more than this. So, you know, look at all of these down here. There's just tons of different ones that you can use. So don't get lost in the templates, though. You really can't. And how many of you are like, oh my gosh, this is my favorite one. Oh no, I want this one. You gotta pick one. So I'm gonna say edit in browser because I want to see how this one works in the browser. And touch continue. Microsoft has done something a little bit different with their templates. Instead of just having one look or kind of a variation of looks, they've given you ways of using the templates. So if you're looking at this, look down the side of yours and see how many different looks are available to you. So you're looking right down this area. I want you to see how many different ways they kind of redesigned this template and this theme to work throughout your entire presentation. So the one thing I liked about this one, if I'm walking through it, there's different looks. There's different ways that now I don't have to think about how does my presentation look. They've already set it up for me. Did they have this before? Yes. But is it a little bit cleaner, crisper, more in your face that you can see the different options? That's the update to it. It's right there for you. And there's different looks like, you know, this one. I have different looks that I can use. So as a teacher and as someone that has a design or presentation, I don't have to start from scratch. One of the things that we find with PowerPoint all the time is the moment someone puts up a PowerPoint, what happens to you? Most of you are like, oh my gosh. And why is that? Because you're going to see at least 30 slides. There's going to be lots of text. But they've tried to change the way they're using this. We're going to talk about Office Mix later, which allows you to take a PowerPoint and turn it into an interactive video. So imagine taking a PowerPoint, you narrate the different slides, and then you package it together and you send it off to your students and they watch it at home and they come in ready to discuss it the next day. So PowerPoint has gotten a complete 180, kind of a complete facelift, really looking at it being a really cool tool versus that tool that used to kind of go to sleep. So the nice thing that I like about these, there are some really unique designs. I mean, this design is different. It wouldn't initially, when I look at it, I'm like, ooh, you can do some fun stuff with that. You can make it look different. It can move different. So I want you to look around at the different templates because there's so many different options out there. So as you look at yours, I want to point out a couple of things again. Notice at the top, that top banner, it changed from blue when we were in Word. It's now orange. So each one has a different color, so you get used to which colors represent which programs. Also, you have the saving feature. So again, it's that document that's going to stay there until I change the name of it. And again, document 13, your presentation 13, go ahead and click on yours so you can change the name of it. I'm going to change mine to test. I know that anything named test means I get to delete it later unless I do something with it. So if I click off of it, I have still the same share settings. If I look through my file menus, my menus are similar to PowerPoint. All of the tools that I have normally used are still here. All the tools that I use on a regular basis are still here. But they're in the online version. I don't have to be on the desktop. that make sense? Yes? All right. So I want you to kind of look at your template, see if there's anything in it that you're like, okay, this is cool, this is different, and then we're gonna segue into how we're gonna use this in a collaborative way. So I'll give you a few minutes just to look at yours, play around with it, and then we're gonna move on. Is that fair?
Pardon?
Is that fair?